Jason Aldworth, former Victorian president, vice president of the Liberal Party. First up, though, Bruce Hawker joins us. Bruce, good to have you back in the country.
Thank you.
Very quickly, now that you've done your tour of the United States and you've focused on politics, would you put your money on Mitt Romney or Barack Obama?
Well, I think it's probably more likely to be Obama at this stage. Yep. But look, as we said last week, anything could happen. But I still feel that in those battleground states, Obama's got the lead that Romney has to run down.
So as long as things don't deteriorate economically in the United States, you think Obama's got it?
That's right. And job figures?
Romney is just too freaky. There's just too much wrong with him, isn't there?
Well, that's the picture they're painting now. And of course, he is there to be painted in that way because we don't really know all that much about him, although we do know a lot about Barack Obama. Employment figures improved in the states last week, so that's another good sign for Obama.
All right, let's talk domestic politics now. Bill Shorten, you know, the end of the weakest was weakest horribilis for him. All of this kerfuffle over the warming of a pie, does this tell us just how touchy things are in the Labor camp?
I guess. Look, I think it really is a tough time for Labor. I remember back in the 1970s when Gough Whitlam was Prime Minister, he had a similar sort of experience, although it was very funny. He went to the grand final of the football in Brisbane, and he was asked by Ron McAuliffe, who was the senator for the Labor Party and president of the Queensland Rugby League, to present the trophy. And of course, when Gough came out and presented the trophy, everyone booed and carried on. He turned around to McAuliffe afterwards and said, "Ron, if I'd known you were that unpopular, I wouldn't have come." So you have to have a good sense of humour in politics all the time.
How bad is this, though, for Shorten, though, given that he is the workplace relations minister?
Look, I think it'll just blow over. I think people understand that it was a misunderstanding.
Yeah.
And
it's not a way to... I mean, we'll move on to other things.
Sure.
But even if it weren't a misunderstanding, even if she had said what he thought she said about Julia Gillard, that is not the way for a minister to behave.
Well, it was a slip, would be the way I'd describe it. I think people in those positions are under constant scrutiny. It's life in a goldfish bowl. You walk down the street, people are talking to you. Some are very friendly, some aren't.
Right.
I don't think much will come of it.
And let's face it, no one wants a pie to be microwaved. gay marriage in Tasmania. Mm. A lot of people will be saying, how can they do this? And if it is possible for the states to make this determination themselves, then why haven't the states been pressured rather than the federal government?
Well, it's interesting, isn't it? It never occurred to me that this was possible, although George Williams, the constitutional lawyer, today is certainly suggesting that it could well be the case, but most likely it'll end up in the High Court. I think the more interesting question is why the Labor Party in Tasmania is going down this path.
Absolutely.
And I think that's got a lot to do with the fact that they're in coalition with the Greens. They have to demonstrate that they've got credentials as well in this area. It's not just the Greens. So they're in a particularly difficult position. They're a minority government like they are in Canberra. And I guess they're also putting a bit of distance between themselves and
Canberra.
I think
also they see some money in it, in the pink dollar. You know, if Tasmania is the only place, it'd attract... You know, everyone will go there to get married.
Yep, well, perhaps they will.
Homosexuals will go there to get married anyway.
Yeah.
Bruce, thank you very much for joining us. Bruce Hawker, their political strategist. Jason Aldworth.